Hi, my name is Kelsey Brosnan. I'm the Curatorial Fellow for European Art here at NOMA. Today I wanted to introduce you to a new installation we have, Paper Revolutions, French Drawings from the New Orleans Museum of Art, which features works on paper from the 18th and the 19th centuries, which come from NOMA's permanent collection. Today I wanted to talk to you about one of my favorite drawings in the show, this work by Jacques-Louis David, who's one of the foremost neoclassical artists of 18th and early 19th century France. And this work is one of my favorites because it comes from rather early in his career. He's just in his early 30s, and he's really just starting to work out the visual language of neoclassicism, which is a sort of art historical term that we use to describe this renewed attention to classical antiquity of Greece and Rome, and also a really particular style, really sharp lines, crisp outlines, and kind of drama related to stories from classical antiquity. So Jacques-Louis David had been a student at the French Royal Academy in Paris when he won a prize, which enabled him to go to Rome and study at the French Academy there. And while he was in Rome, he became obsessed with classical antiquity and archaeology, and he really made tons and tons of drawings while he was there of all the sort of sculptures and architecture that he observed while he was there. And when he got back to Paris, he was trying to work out his ideas for a great painting, his first major work as a young artist. And he was going through his sort of notes and drawings that he had made while he was in Rome. And he first sort of started to develop an idea for a painting with this work, The Murder of Geta. And it tells a really kind of violent story of power and corruption from the Roman emperor. Caracalla, who you can see there, who's holding this sword dripping in blood. And you can see that he is attacking this other young man, that's in fact his brother, Geta, who has fled to the arms of their mother. They had been ruling the Roman Empire together after the death of their father, Septimius Severus, but Caracalla got greedy and wanted to seize total power and control of the empire for himself. So he murders his brother Geta. So David was working out his ideas with this drawing, planning to paint a much larger painting that would be his sort of first major work to be exhibited at the Parisian Salon in Paris. And art historians have really kind of struggled with this particular work in David's oeuvre because David ultimately never ends up executing that painting. He turns to a totally different subject. But what's important about this work is that we can see, sort of percolating in David's sort of draftsmanship, this sort of urgency and drama and power and this obsession with politics in particular. And later on in his career, David becomes really deeply involved in the French Revolution. He becomes part of this committee that executes traitors to the Republic, anyone who's perceived as being loyal to the crown. And so art historians, looking back on David's earlier work, try and kind of read these kind of political inclinations into his choice of subject in particular. And that's why I think this drawing is so fascinating, because it represents, on one hand, this kind of idea that never really fully comes to fruition, but also this kind of early hints of David's own political inclinations, which are really fascinating, I think. Well, thank you for joining us on this Instagram Live Curator Spotlight, and come see the Paper Revolutions, which will be on view until July.